Ladies and gentlemen, good morning, and welcome to the University of Adelaide graduation ceremony. This morning's ceremony is for graduates from the Adelaide Law School. The ceremony will commence very shortly. The university has a contract photographer to provide photography service during the ceremony. If you wish to take photos during the ceremony, I would ask that you do so discreetly from your seat, and please do not use flash. To maintain the ceremony's decorum, could you also please switch off your mobile phones if you haven't already? For safety reasons, I would ask guests not to enter the galleries upstairs, and please do not sit on the steps in the balcony area. In the event of an emergency, please follow the instructions of the security officers and the ushers. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, the academic procession is about to enter the hall. We will be singing the national anthem. The words are on page 11 of the program. Please be upstanding for the academic procession and national anthem.
I, Kevin Johns, Guest, Chancellor of the University of Adelaide, declare open this congregation convened for the purpose of presenting degrees. Distinguished guests, parents, relatives, friends, and especially our graduates, welcome to the University of Adelaide's graduation ceremony. I wish to acknowledge the Kaurna people, the original custodians of the Adelaide Plains, and the land upon which the University of Adelaide's campuses at North Terrace, Waite, Theberden and Roseworthy are built. Might I start by offering my congratulations to all of our graduates. Today's a special day for you and no doubt for your family and friends who I have no doubt have been instrumental in supporting you through your education and through your degree. Today's a day of reflection. Acknowledgement of what you have achieved and also anticipation for what's to come. There's every reason for us to be optimistic about the future. There will certainly be challenges, but I've no doubt that you've overcome hurdles to get where you are today, so you can be confident about your ability to manage those challenges into the future. There is enormous opportunity in our state, in our nation, for you to contribute to the world that you want to see in the future. So with the same enthusiasm and purpose that has enabled you to graduate today, if you take that approach to the next phase of your life, then no doubt you will be as successful as you have been today. So go out, enjoy your life, and contribute to the world that you want to see in the future. It now gives me great pleasure to introduce today's graduation orator, Associate Professor Suzanne Lamar. After practicing at Piper Alderman, Associate Professor Lamar moved to academia, where she was first appointed Associate Professor and Associate Dean, Learning and Teaching at the Adelaide Law School, University of Adelaide. In 2016, Suzanne was appointed Dean of Law. Associate Professor Lamar research work on corporate law, corporate governance and legal ethics has been published in a number of highly regarded national and international journals. She is regularly invited to speak at a variety of public and professional events. This has included presentations to the Law Society of South Australia, the Australian Corporate Lawyers Association, the Hong Kong Law Society, the Hong Kong Institute of Directors, the Hong Kong Securities and Futures Commission, and many others. She's also been invited to speak to ASIC and the Law Institute of Victoria. Suzanne has been a distinguished overseas visitor at the Chinese University of Hong Kong and visiting scholar, University College London. Associate Professor Lamar is a member of the South Australian Judicial Development Committee, an editor of the International Journal Legal Ethics, secretary to the Australian Corporate Law Teachers Association, and a member of the International Association of Legal Ethics. In 2012, Suzanne was awarded the fellowship of the National Institute for Teaching of Ethics and Professionalism based in Georgia State University in recognition of her teaching activities. In 2015, Suzanne, together with the team at the law school, were the recipients of the Executive Dean Award for Excellence in Teaching for her activities for first-year law students. We are indeed privileged to have her speak today. Please welcome Associate Professor Suzanne Lamar.
Thank you, Chancellor. Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, distinguished guests, colleagues, family and friends, and most importantly, graduates. In reflecting on speaking with you today, I felt I needed to have a series of pithy life lessons to share with you. Lessons that would send you out to the world all sorted, ready to face the challenges life will inevitably bring. And so I reflected. I drank tea. I Googled. I read the Objects Clause in the Corporations Act. I reflected again. I did some yoga. I read Churchill's speeches. I tried cake. I reflected some more. Growing desperate, I read Plato. I Googled some more. I read the 10 best graduation speeches of all time, and I collected the lessons of those for you. They advocated courage, failure, liking yourself, staying alive, selflessness, not multitasking, having a high threshold for frustration, integrity, world peace, and making your bed every morning. All undoubtedly laudable goals, but they didn't quite capture my life lessons. I walked on the beach, I read Justice Kirby's dissenting judgment in Thomas and Mowbray. I ate more cake. Sadly, after all these efforts, I had only my personal favourite writing mantra, full stops are your friends. Familiar as this is to those who know me well, I felt it was a slim peg upon which to send you out into the world. So I propose instead to tell you two stories. Our first story is about a small boy, perhaps 3 or 4 years old, who's been hung by his overalls from the branch of a tree in Upper Michigan. It's 1932. The boy is crying, as the branch from which he has been hung is high and he cannot get down. Those of you with an eye for detail will see he has a caliper on his left foot. He's been born with a twisted foot, such that he cannot walk without a limp. He's been placed in the tree by his father, frustrated by having a child with a disability at a time when a disability is seen as a failing. We will leave him there. For the soft-hearted amongst you, he is rescued by his older brother. And we'll rejoin him some years later when he's 12 and immobilised while enduring a long series of operations. Indeed, he spends most of his childhood in hospital. The operations ultimately correct his foot so he's able to walk normally. And his mother, now on her own, purchases $25 earned by taking in laundry, a set of 25 red cloth bound volumes that contain the works of authors from Robert Louis Stevenson to Shakespeare. The boy opens the first volume and is transported. He now leaves us, pulled into the world of literature. Around the same time the little boy is placed in the tree, but half a world away, a young law student at the Adelaide Law School is turned away from the Law Student Society. She's refused membership not because of any flaw in character or poor record of scholarship. Indeed, ultimately, she graduates with a prize for the most outstanding student of her year. Nor is she undeserving, having been the child who ran full pelt to the front door to meet her father first at the end of his working day. She loses her beloved father in the First World War and only makes it to university due to the determined support of her mother and the generosities of the Sisters of Mercy who provide her free education. Nor is she flighting, this young student. She has seen family members work in the law and has been, according to one source, from age 6, committed to a career in the law. She is, however, faced with considerable challenges. She is refused membership of the Law Students Society purely because of her gender. While remarkably, 6 of the 30 students in her year at law school are women, they make their way through the year without the benefits, through the degree without the benefits of tutorials, as these are only available if you live at residential colleges, and these are only open to men, and indeed men of considerable means. Mooting is similarly out of the question due to her gender. Undaunted, she founds the Adelaide Women's Law Student Society, a society that was a feature of my time at the law school some 50 years later. She also encourages female students to organise their own mooting competitions, and after her graduation, she similarly organises dinners for women lawyers when the annual Law Society dinners prove to be an exclusively male domain. We will again shift our focus, leaving this young woman to meet adversity with courage and ingenuity. Each of these stories demonstrates that real adversity can lead to opportunity. In each case, roadblocks and disappointments were overcome with courage and determination. In the words of the poet Robert Frost, two roads diverged in the wood, and I took the road less travelled by, and that has made all the difference. The little boy becomes the first in his family to go to university. He studies literature, obtains a PhD, moves halfway across the world for love, takes up an academic post, and with the 25-volume set still on his bookshelf, he becomes a professor of English literature. This story is personal. He is my father, and he sits amongst you today. Our second story is your story too. It is that of Dame Roma Mitchell, QC, Supreme Court Judge, Chancellor of the University of Adelaide, Governor, a law reformer, like you, a graduate of the University of Adelaide Law School, a tireless advocate for human rights in the days when, in her words, they were just called rights, who, once she stepped down from the Supreme Court bench, delivered Meals on Wheels to the elderly and disabled residents of dingy Adelaide boarding houses. Throughout her life, Dame Roma faced adversity and saw in this an opportunity to forge a new path. If I listed all her firsts, merits, and awards, we will be here all day. While her story is in many ways one of triumph, she would undoubtedly be disappointed to hear that the battle for equal pay for women, a cause for which she advocated as early as the 1960s, is as yet not won. Recent figures for the legal profession in South Australia reveal that women lawyers 8 to 16 years from graduation earn roughly two-thirds of their male counterparts. For the family and friends here today, a theme of these stories is the great gifts that are given by family and friends. The little boy who's given the 25-volume set by a mother who herself probably never read a book from beginning to end. The law student who's supported by a determined mother and a scholarship after her father dies. As you enjoy this moment, I'm sure your graduate remembers the support, hot chocolate and toasties you provided when everything seemed bleak, and the times you shared their joy when things went well. It is these gifts, freely given with love, for which we are all deeply thankful. For the graduates, there are many difficulties and opportunities ahead. Many will be hard, some will be expected, others surprising. Each will change you just as this degree, your opportunity, your education, but also each difficulty you have already overcome has transformed you. Over the course of the degree, you have learnt a great deal, not only about legal method and the contents of the Corporations Act, but also about yourselves. Not just about the pleasures of Professor Syme's lectures on insolvency, Professor Williams' interpretation of the Constitution, and Professor Stewart's view of contract law, but also the key values of our discipline. Just as your preference for corporate law or human rights law is part of you, so these discipline values are now part of you as well. That is who we, you and I, and many of those who sit behind me are together as law graduates. The early Superman cartoons put our values well. It's truth and justice, before the more patriotic and the American way was added. Truth and justice, that is who we are. But it is more than that as well. Law is a discipline that's committed to combating adversity, to speaking for those who cannot speak for themselves. That is who we are. We are committed to fairness in both substance and process. We believe the end doesn't justify the means, but rather that both must be just and fair. That is who we are. We believe that law matters, that a reasoned case, a well-drafted statute, and a comprehensive treaty can change the world. That is who we are. We believe that the answer to a problem can be found using IRAC. That is who we are. We believe that carefully crafted legal institutions can transform a nation state into a place of opportunity and justice. That is who we are. We believe that being a professional means something, that it places obligations on us to act ethically, honestly, and justly. That is who we are. You are now at the edge of opportunity. You have earned this opportunity and will rightly enjoy the glory today brings. Your degree is a grand achievement that places you in the footsteps of distinguished graduates such as Dame Roma. But your responses to your future adversities and opportunities, wherever your degree takes you, will be your grandest achievement yet. May your onward journey be as surprising, challenging, and ultimately fruitful as that of the characters in our stories. May your adversities become your opportunities. May you take the road less travelled and find it wonderful. Because that is who you are. And so I return to where I began. Full stops are your friends, and I wish you all the very best.
Well done.
On behalf of all the graduates and their families attending today's ceremony, I would like to thank Associate Professor Suzanne Lemire for her stimulating and inspiring address. We are honoured that you have taken the time to join us on this special day to share with us your thoughts and experiences. Your words of encouragement and advice are greatly appreciated. They remind us that education places upon each of us an enduring responsibility to make the best possible use of our talents and to contribute to the betterment of society in whatever way we can. Please join me once again in thanking Associate Professor Suzanne Lemire.
I will now receive the candidates for degrees. I call upon the Vice-Chancellor.
Chancellor, I, Professor Warren Bebbington, Vice-Chancellor and President of the University of Adelaide, certify to you and the whole university that the graduates who will be presented to you have fulfilled all the conditions prescribed for admission to the awards for which they are so presented.
I, Kevin Johns, guest, Chancellor of the University of Adelaide, by virtue of the power committed to me by the University, confirm that each graduate is admitted to the rank and privileges of a holder of the award in the University of Adelaide for which they are so presented.
Chancellor, I, Professor Christopher Symes, present to you graduates from the Adelaide Law School. To the degree of Bachelor of Laws, Benjamin John Alberton. Benjamin also receives the Bachelor of Science. Julian Amato. Joshua Anderson Ward. Patrick Lawrence Anderson. Patrick also receives the Bachelor of Economics. Rebecca Lillian Andreessen. Emily May Louise Angwin. Charlotte Louise Aykroyd. Simon Alexander Bell Ailes. Grace Cynthia Aurelie Banner. Grace also receives the Bachelor of Media. Benjamin Biyan Baru. Imogen Elise Basado. Sayaday Leila Bayatnatia. Lawrence Daniel Beltrami. Lawrence also receives the Bachelor of Science. Gemma Borello. Matthew Roy Boyle. Candice Brianna Caretti. Laurie Jean Caruso. Liam Patrick Casey. Stephen James Chenoweth. Alexander Wei Ming Chu. Alexander also receives the Bachelor of Arts. Elian Pei San Chung. Karina Rose Conway. Alyssa Brooke Coulter. Cameron James Coventry. Joshua Mark Danahay. Joshua also receives the Bachelor of Commerce, International Business and the Diploma in Languages. Martha Elizabeth Delport. Laura Jane Dickinson. Laura also receives the Bachelor of Commerce, Accounting. Lucy Jean Dinnison Mitchell. John Charles Shepherd Dolman. Ella Frances Dunstan. Mindy Jane Ellis. Mindy also receives the Bachelor of Commerce, International Business and the Diploma in Languages. Liam Gordon Elul. Matthew James Frigona. Konstantinos Glikos. Victoria Anne Delise Griffin. Victoria also receives the Bachelor of Media. K Kirsten K. Hatwell. Jordan Grace Hearn. Jordan also receives the Bachelor of Commerce Marketing. Alexis Ilsa Jaime. Anna Teresa Hepworth. Olivia Ching Poi Hon. Nicholas James Horvat. Fiona Kate Hurley. Nara Alira O'Loughlin. Charles William Inglis. Charles also receives the Bachelor of Arts. Zach Thomas Jackman. Cree June Gia. James Richard Jordan. James also receives the Bachelor of Arts. Anastasi Karatasa. Rohan Ziha Kahambata. Megan Julie Adeline Kilday. Megan also receives the Bachelor of Arts. Yelena Nezvich. Sue Fay Coe. Daniel Frank Cradolfa. Daniel also receives the Bachelor of Arts. Woon Hay Jason Lam. Brittany Nee Jade Law. Kieran James Linda. Elena Araceli Luna. Christopher Mooney Mahoney. Jaeger Christopher Mann. Jaeger also receives the Bachelor of Health Sciences. Brandon Manuel Augustin Martin. John Matsis. John also receives the Bachelor of Commerce Management and the Diploma in Languages. Henry David May. Henry also receives the Bachelor of International Studies. Tarek Ismail Mazzio. Shannon Kate McMenninum. Shannon also receives the Bachelor of Commerce, International Business. Annabelle Georgia McNeil. Annabelle also receives the Bachelor of Arts and the Diploma in Languages. Jessica Sarah Nankerville. Benjamin James Newell. Wing Yu Oh. Wing also receives the Bachelor of Science. Laura Frances Nutt. Laura also receives the Bachelor of Arts. Sarah Elizabeth O'Brien. Sarah also receives the Bachelor of Arts. Kylie Ann O'Loughlin. Osagabovo E. C. Osa Ojo. Cheryl Shao Yeong. Cheryl also receives the Bachelor of Commerce Accounting. Melvin Paul. Queen Anne Pham. Farah Pink Duhim. Maria Podobny. Ashish Ponna. Ashish also receives the Bachelor of International Studies. Jack Alexander Prance. Jack also receives a Diploma in Languages. Shivani Raja Jandran. Sala Marumutu Reddy. William Patrick Rees. Annabelle Jane Reeve. Annabelle also receives the Bachelor of Commerce Marketing. Emily Diane Rowe. Iqbal Hussain Safari. David Alexander Sartoris. Claire Elizabeth Smythe. Claire also receives the Bachelor of International Studies. Duncan Edmund Song. Terry Soulmatis. Andrew Turnbull Sykes. Samuel Asher Talbot. Chiwei Tan. Simon James Torpy. Simon also receives the Bachelor of Arts. Julie Tran. Tyler John Trenery. Tyler also receives the Bachelor of International Studies. Tam Tu. Michael Tudor Sortos. Michael also receives the Bachelor of Commerce, Corporate Finance. Tegan Marie Turner. Georgina Emmanuel Watson. Mary Rose Westling. Claire Ryan Wiebe. Claire also receives the Bachelor of Psychological Science. Christopher John Wilkins. Eleanor Catherine Wilcox. Eleanor also receives the Bachelor of Arts. Victoria May Worrell. Parissa Zaruni. Stephen Spilios Zakopoulos. And Yui Chow Zhou.
Do I have to read that out?
Leanne Goh also receives a Bachelor of Arts. To the degree of Bachelor of Laws with Honours, Arabella Elise Allen. Elizabeth Alvaro. Hudson Gilfillan Marcher. Ashley Liao Yu Lin. Floyd David Bakewell. Kieran James Banks. Benjamin John Perry Bishop. Patrick Robert Bollen. Lucy Giordana Bozzetti. Rees Mark Braybrook. Kate Ellen Bruce. Stephanie Charlotte Campbell. Emily Ann Carr. Chaiyong Wei. Sean Jane Chapman. Etty Sham Reza Chowdhury. Liwei Chua. Sophie Lee Siganovic. James Martin Kobiak. Matilda Sarah May Conlon. Travis Charles Cordingley. Travis also receives the Bachelor of Commerce, Corporate Finance. Kirsty Craig. Kirsty also receives the Bachelor of Science. Natasha Denise Cruikshank. Daniel Anthony D'Onofrio. Harrison Andrew Darcy. Harrison also receives the Bachelor of Commerce, Corporate Finance. Karina Louise Durden. Karina also receives the Bachelor of Arts. Anna G. Dierman. Anthony Delo. Catherine Jane Draper. Isabella Catherine Dunning. Isabella also receives the Bachelor of Arts. Georgina Diana Evans. Matilda Rose Fagan Schmidt. Caitlin Marianne Feligvari. Caitlin also receives the Bachelor of Arts. Ashley Jean Fitzgerald. Ashley also receives the Diploma in Languages. Ella Rose Fox. Catherine Louise Fritz. Catherine also receives the Bachelor of Commerce, Corporate Finance. Isabella Sinead Fife. Caitlin Elizabeth Galpin. Caitlin also receives the Bachelor of International Studies. Joanna Ellen Gates. Joanna also receives the Bachelor of Arts. Diana Michelle Gatto. Amy Kate Giles. Amy also receives the Bachelor of Commerce, Corporate Finance. Marie Louise Giuliano. Joel Anthony Greger. Joshua Gugliotta. Amy Carissa Ganawan. Daisy Hamra. Daisy also receives the Bachelor of Commerce, Corporate Finance and the Diploma in Languages. Wei He. Madeline Alexandra Henry. Zephyr May Hicks. Patrick Thomas Holland. Patrick also receives the Bachelor of Arts. Scott Allen Hunt. Ethna Johnston. Robert John Katsambas. James Lanus. David Robert Lane. James Stilly Arnos Langanis. James also receives the Bachelor of International Studies and the Diploma in Languages. Miles David Leslie. Alexandra Lontras. Lucas Robert Lovell. Megan Bridget Lowe. Megan also receives the Bachelor of Arts. Andrew Bryce Robert Lukovich. Katarzyna Isabel Makzuga. Jack Anthony Madigan Manuel. Trin Thuy Mai. William Stewart Maitland. Siobhan Michelle McGee. Siobhan also receives the Diploma in Languages. Cullum Henry Douglas McNair. Anthony William Milton. Jessica Christine Mirrell. Edward Andrew Mitchell. Claire Rose Moffat. Maud Nazif, Maud Nasri. Celia Catherine Moody. Oliver Hugh Morris. Kumara Guru Nayi Kerr Muruthi. Alexander Raymond Netheim. Alexander also receives the Bachelor of Commerce Marketing. Alexandra Nicola. Ashton Ari Papazaharayakis. Joshua Ross Pascal. Jasmine Monique Patterson. Jacob Andrew Paul. Bridget Claire Pecker. Nisha Piera. Madeline Tiara Lilo Pio Chauve. Igor Popov. Montana Pripich. Montana also receives the Bachelor of Commerce, Corporate Finance and the Diploma in Languages. Kenneth Martin Richards. Taylor Warwick Rundle. Leah Jasmine Sagen Schnittner. Leah also receives the Diploma in Languages. Joshua Blake Schultz. Hugo Caden Shaw. Daria Shigapova. Daria also receives the Bachelor of Finance. Carl Peter Hudson Seabells. Johannes Maximilian Sieverts van Riesma. Neville Craig Smith. Neville also receives the Bachelor of Economics and the Diploma in Languages. Grace Smythe Bolland. Arjun Sridhar. Alexander Robert Stanley. Alexander also receives the Bachelor of Environmental Policy and Management and the Diploma in Languages. Jeddah Stocks Ramsey. Jeddah also receives the Bachelor of International Studies. Bridget Mary Anna Symes. Bridget also receives the Diploma in Languages. Mary Elizabeth Helena Zumalo. Peter Daniel Theodoro. Bradley Stewart Thomas. Bradley also receives the Bachelor of Commerce Accounting. Charlotte Ann Thomas. Elizabeth Hobbs Teeman. Elizabeth also receives the Bachelor of Commerce Marketing. Daniel Brian Tracy. Rebecca Lee Venning. David Alexander Vincent. David also receives the Bachelor of Science. Rachel Ann Way. Jonathan Mark Wenham. Melissa Wei Lee Wong. Sarah Mei Wen Wong. Wong Siong Long. Henry Alexander Healy Wild. Timothy Michael Zammit. And David Yichen Jiang. To the Graduate Diploma in Legal Practice, Gerard Francis Ferreau. Henry Arthur James. Henry also receives the Bachelor of Laws. Munira Osman. And Michele Giuseppe Pagnano. To the Master's degree of Master of Laws and Master of Commerce Applied Finance, Richard John Mager. To the degree of Master of Laws and Master of Applied Finance, Shi Ya Chin. To the degree of Master of Laws, Xing Jiao Yu. To the degree of Master of Business Law, Alina Maria Gomez Chavarro. Chancellor, this now concludes the presentation of graduates.
Chancellor, every year the university presents university medals to acknowledge the most outstanding graduates in each faculty who have completed a University of Adelaide bachelor's degree with honours or bachelor's degree of at least 4 years' duration. The university medals are awarded to them for their consistently outstanding performance across the whole of their undergraduate studies. I, Professor Warren Bebbington, Vice-Chancellor and President of the University of Adelaide, present to you the winner of the 2015 University Medal for the Faculty of the Professions, Elizabeth Alvaro. Chancellor, University Doctoral Research Medals are awarded to graduates who have completed outstanding research at doctoral level. This award is the premier award for doctoral candidates at this university. I, Professor Warren Bebbington, Vice-Chancellor and President of the University of Adelaide, present to you the winner of the 2015 University Doctoral Research Medal. For research in the field of law, Manuel Peter Samonte Solis.
Now gives me great pleasure to congratulate all of our new graduates here today. Be proud of what you've worked for, what you've achieved, and certainly remember those who've supported you through the journey. I wish you every success as you enter this new exciting phase of your life. As graduates of the University of Adelaide, you are its alumni and ambassadors. Over the years since the university was established, our alumni have made an enormous contribution to the community, both here and throughout the world. And today you join a community of over 150,000 alumni located in 80 countries around the globe. I'd like to acknowledge and thank the Mace Bearer and also those who've assisted in running today's ceremony. Universities are more than wonderful, lovely brick and mortar that we're enjoying here this morning. The university's strengths and its people, its staff and its faculty. And we are blessed here in this university to have outstanding staff and faculty help guide our students through their journey. And I wish to acknowledge their contribution both today and my expectations of the future. Thank you. I'd ask all the graduates to remain seated and the rest of us stand and join me in congratulating our graduates. Well, our graduates now stand as we prepare for the academic recession. I now declare this congregation adjourned.